Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the previous video, you had an introduction to the scopes and how they work in the editorial context. We also finished off with how to customize your own presets. In this video, we'll examine the scopes in the context of a VFX scenario, and we'll cover grading, comparisons, and color management. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. So starting in batch, set up a 2UP view with Alt-2 and load some media to work with. In my case, I have loaded some media which is tagged as Rec 709 video. In the result view on the right, you can see the image of the selected source clip. At any time, you can call up the contextual menu over the viewport and choose to show scopes. As I mentioned in the previous video, the scopes are part of the viewports and not any specific module. So whatever nodes you select in your flow graph will have their results analyzed by the scopes. So you could use this with different viewport configurations. And if you were using a dual monitor configuration on your system, the viewports could be displayed in the second screen as you work in batch or the timeline view. Now call up the contextual menu and hide the scopes for a moment. So video scopes will work with any node from the batch node bin. But the node I want to focus on for the next few minutes is the color warper node. Drag one out of the batch node bin and connect the media into the front input. In previous versions of the Flame products, the color warper was the only VFX module that had an inbuilt vector scope for grading and color matching. This scope has been removed in favor of having the scopes available in all the VFX modules through the viewports. So if you want to use the vector scope with the color warper, call up the contextual menu over the image and show the scopes. Depending on what preset you had previously chosen, will now be displayed in the viewport. Call up the contextual menu again and choose Scopes, Presets, and Color Warper. This preset gives you the exact same functionality as before, just with the enhanced scopes. I'll zoom and pan the vector scope with the Control Space and Space keyboard shortcuts. Now, when making adjustments to any value, the scopes will interactively update. This is the same for any VFX module, and you will see this in the waveform scopes as well as the 3D cube. But what is really cool about the color warper is the ability to reference a color and plot towards it. The vector scope plays a big part in that workflow. For example, go to the bottom of the interface and click the ref button. Now click and reference a specific color in your image. Note that the reference sample is now highlighted by the circle in the vector scope. Now click the plot button. This will define the color that you'd like to manipulate. Click the specific color in the image that you'd like to adjust. Next, drag the midtones ball and you can align the plot sample to the reference sample, and this will shift and match the colors. This is great for white balancing or grading an image with its own color palette. As a tip, if you wanted to clear the reference and plot circles in the scope, call up the contextual menu, choose Scopes, and clear sample highlights. So I think you get that there is loads of potential in terms of look development with all the grading tools in Flame. Now, one very useful aspect about the scopes in all scenarios is comparing a before and after. In any module, including the color warper, you could simply toggle between the front view and result view using the F1 and F4 keyboard shortcuts. Aside from the visual change in the image, the scopes analyze whatever you see in the viewers, so they will update accordingly. Now that's very useful, but sometimes, from an analysis point of view, it is more useful to see the reference and the result at the same time in the scopes. So here are some more comparison options that you can use. For example, let's just change to a different tool for variety's sake. Delete the color warper and locate the look node in the batch node bin. Drag it out and connect the media. Double-clicking on the node will bring up its toolset. Now I want the scopes to fill the right viewport and have the result in the left. Call up the contextual menu, choose Scopes, Presets, and Trio. So now you have multiple scopes visible. Select the look node in the batch schematic and press F4 for the result view. Now have a bit of fun and give your image a look. So now you've created a stylized look on your image, and you'd like to compare that to the original. I've already mentioned toggling the front and result view with F1 and F4. But when using the comparison mode, you get additional level of feedback using the scopes and their widgets. Click the Compare button or press Ctrl B. When it comes to comparisons, you can choose from a number of sources to compare to. For instance, you could grab a frame earlier using Ctrl G. But clicking the reference pull-down menu, you can choose from a variety of sources, including any set contextual views. Choose the front option to compare the result with the incoming source. As soon as you enable the compare functionality and choose the reference image, the scopes will now display the reference analysis and the graded result. So as you continue to adjust the look, the scope's result will update, and you can compare that to the reference that was set. As a tip, if the color of the reference analysis does not work for you, call up the scope settings through the contextual menu, and under Presets, you can change the reference color to whatever you want. You have access to the full color picker and set any color that works best for you. So you have the benefit of a technical comparison by looking at the scopes. But don't forget, you can also drag the split bar on the image for a visual cross-section comparison. Now let's move on to our final subject, which is color management. Disable the compare button and switch back to the batch schematic. Delete the look node if you want, and select your source clip. First off, the video scopes are color managed in Flame. If you go to the main Flame menu and choose Preferences, Color Management, you will see an option called Monitoring Color Space. Whatever view you are using with your scopes can be calibrated to the correct color space in order to visualize the correct colors and luminance. Mine is currently set to view everything through Rec. 709 video, which is supported by my current display. Now exit the preferences. Secondly, when you select media that has been tagged with a color space, the scopes will adjust to correctly display the analysis of that media within its tagged color space. So toggling between this Rec. 709 clip and a clip tagged as ACES-CG will update the scopes, and you can see the view transforms assigned to the scopes. It is also possible to switch the view transforms if you wish to see colors analyzed through a different viewing transform. So to be clear, you are viewing a color-managed clip through its tagged viewing transform via the scopes, and this is currently monitored on a Rec. 709 display device. Next, we need to discuss the scope's overlays in terms of color space. In order to do this, call up the contextual menu over the scopes, choose Scopes, and Settings. Switch to the Preferences menu. Under Global Settings, you will see that the overlays are defaulted to Rec. 709. When you switch the overlays to any other color space, the color markings on the vector scope will adjust to accommodate the color space of your choice. Finally, you have one last option called Apply Diagnostics. This has to do with the exposure, contrast, and gamma settings on the viewport. For example, hide the scopes through the contextual menu. Hold Shift E and adjust the viewport exposure. As a reminder, you are only changing the viewport exposure and not the image's actual colors. If you switch back to the scopes, you will notice that the analysis is still the same because the diagnostics are not taken into account. Even if you adjust the exposure setting again while looking at the scopes, the analysis won't change. Now activate Apply Diagnostics. The scopes start considering the viewport diagnostics, and when you change the exposure again, the scopes will react accordingly. Please note that the diagnostics are viewport specific. So if you select the clip in the batch schematic and switch to the result view, adjusting the exposure on this viewport will not affect the scopes in the other viewport. Selecting the viewport with the scopes and hiding them will reveal the image that is being affected by the diagnostic controls, and this is what's reflected in the scopes. If you don't want your scopes to be affected by any viewport diagnostics, remember to turn the setting off in the scope settings preferences. So that concludes how to use scopes in the Flame 2018.3 update. And hopefully, your scopes will be useful in your technical and creative finishing in the Flame products. Please be sure to check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.